Hi guys, and welcome back to another IBRACORP video. Thanks for tuning in. As usual, I just want to give a quick thanks to everyone who likes and subscribes to the channel. You know, I really appreciate it. It's obviously showing that the work is getting out there and it's really helping people, so I couldn't be happier. So thank you for that. And if you haven't, please think about subscribing. It really helps out. Today, I'm just going to go through, hopefully it's going to be a quick video, on how to use your own domain and have a custom email address using Gmail without having to pay for anything like formerly known as G Suite or a paid mail provider. I will stress that this isn't the best approach. It's not the industry standard approach, and you may find that emails used in this fashion could end up in a lot of junk email folders if you're trying to send out. But look, in my case, I just haven't jumped over to another service yet. It is in the pipeline, and I will make a video about that in future when we switch over. But for the past probably year, I've been using this method so that I can use a Gmail account and on the other end have professional looking email addresses that people can contact and then have them in my inbox in Gmail. So you know the motto, let's just get stuck into it. So I'm here in my Google account for IBRACORP, and our email address with IBRACORP is ibracorp.io@gmail.com. Okay, now that doesn't look like anything too fancy. That's just a normal Gmail account. Although the real magic happens here in your domain. So if you are using Google domains, this is where you would be making the changes. If you're using any other domain provider, you'll have to find their email section, and I assume that it'll probably be very similar. Basically, under the email section, you'll see an option here for get a custom email address. So this is where they try to sell you Google Workspace, which formerly used to be known as G Suite. And this allows you to have a custom email address. However, you have to pay for it. So if you wanted to do it if you are a business and you wanted to do this on a real professional level, I do recommend the Google Workspace. However, you know, if you're just doing a home lab and you want to have that professional sort of appearance and have that professional relationship with your customers, then just scroll down a little bit and you'll see here email forwarding. So all this does is it allows you to pick an address with your domain as the ending and you just get it to forward to your Gmail account. Okay, this is phase one. The next phase after this, which I'll show you, is how we configure it in Gmail so that you can also send from this address. So that we can send from this address, for example, or this one, or any of these other ones that we've set up. So just for the purpose of this video, I'm actually going to create a new one and we'll go add email alias. Under the alias email, we can put YouTube, and as you can see, the ending is already there because it's going by our domain. So then the existing recipient email will be our Gmail account. Like so. And then we click add. Now that's pretty much it for this screen. If you've watched my previous video on setting up Cloudflare, which I recommend you do, I walk through adding a couple of DNS entries into our DNS, and those are the MX records. So I'll go back to them real quick. So we're back in Cloudflare here, just to show you what the MX records look like. So without these MX records here, you won't be able to get your Gmail account to work sending emails via the domain. So you need to make sure that you've got these in here. So if I just click on this one, for example, you see the breakdown of what makes up this entry. So we've got the domain name, the mail server, automatic time to live, and the priorities. So the priorities are all important as well. This is given directly from Google. If you were to go to their documentation, this is how they have written it. So I'm just saving you time by reading it here. So as you can see, same thing applies. And you can pretty much just copy these guys if you're using Gmail as your mail provider. If you're using any other mail provider, SMTP server, your settings will be different, but you need to make sure that these MX entries are here on your DNS, even if they're a different mail provider, okay? And each mail provider will have their own instructions anyway and what to put in there. So I would recommend just, you know, if you're with MailChimp, MailGun, whatever, follow those instructions, okay? But in our case, we're using Gmail. So we've already made sure that this is in our DNS, and then we can continue with where we left off. So we've created our YouTube at IBRACORP.io, and it forwards to our Gmail account. All right, so let's say you want to now send out from your Gmail as YouTube at IBRACORP. Well, pretty simple. We'll go to settings. Go to see all settings. Accounts and import. And as you can see, I've got a few in here already. We're going to add a new one. So it's going to open up this pop-up. So we've given it a name, IBRACORP YouTube. And for the email address, it'll be the one that we've set up on our domain. We'll click on treat it as an alias. If I'm sending from this address, I want replies to come back to this address as well. But if you didn't, you can specify a different reply to. Okay, so you can put like no reply, for example, or something like that. We'll click next step. So in here, it's going to put in what it thinks your SMTP server is. In our case, because we're using Gmail, we will say smtp@gmail.com. The username is going to be your Gmail email address, okay? Because that is technically your username with Gmail. Now for the password. So to be able to use this, you actually need to use what they call app passwords, okay? You can't just use your account password for Gmail. And this provides you an extra layer of security because at any point you can just remove the app passwords. So if you don't know how to do that, you need to get to your Google account. So as you can see, this is our Google account here. Then you can go to security, and under security you'll see app passwords. Let's just hit that. It's going to ask you to sign in. We'll just do that. And as you can see, I've got some existing ones here. It does not let you see an existing app password once you've created it, okay? It only lets you remove it. And that's part of the security implementation of the whole process, is that you create it once, and wherever it is, it's there only once. And then for new ones, you would create new ones, and you can remove them as well. So as you can see here, app passwords let you sign into your Google account from apps on devices that don't support two-step verification. You'll only need to enter it once, so you don't need to remember it. Click select app, mail, and we'll say other, and we'll just call this YouTube email address, for example. We'll click generate, and now it's going to give us this password. So for those watching, don't worry, I'll end up deleting this after the video, but for our purpose here, we want this password. So you can just highlight it and click copy. I recommend leaving this open for now. Head back to that little pop-up we had, and where it asks for password, we'll just put password in there. Make sure your port is 587 if you're using SMTP for Gmail, because it is the TLS port, so it is a secure port. So make sure secured connection using TLS is checked. And then click add account. So the next screen you'll see is, it's going to send you a code to verify. So if we go back to our email address, and we head over to our updates, you'll see here that it's given us a code. So just make sure you copy that code, paste the code in, click verify, and that should be it. So now if we go to a new email, compose a new email, you can see we've got YouTube here as an option to send from. And that basically lets you send it anywhere and appear from that address. And as you can tell, it just looks a lot more professional. So the only sort of downside that I've found using this process is, like I said, some emails will end up in the receiver's spam, and that really depends on a lot of things. I think you have to make sure your emails are compliant with relevant regulations, such as having an unsubscribe option, you know, things like that. So, you know, it may not be the best long-term solution, and I'm happy to admit that. But if you want something to get you going and want to look professional without costing you anything and avoid using just a gmail.com account, you know, this is a great option for you. And, you know, you can always ask people if it's going to be something static to just make sure that they keep the address whitelisted. So I hope that's helped. If you need any more assistance, please comment down below. I know it's just a brief one, but it's one that I get asked quite a bit, and it's a really easy one to do. So I hope it's helped you out, and I look forward to seeing you in the next video.